I would like to go back to the concept of the Anād Khand. If you could phrase these three moments, including what happened 3 years ago. So how can we frame the history of the Anād Khand so far? What do you envision in the immediate future? Because it seems that it's starting again with a stronger support of the Punjab state.
You see, it is a very strange story. Any intelligent governance would welcome any attempt and effort to conserve heritage by people who have spent their entire lifetimes in the service without any remuneration or any commercial intent and without commodifying the knowledge they are trying to conserve. It is unfortunate, it's disgusting, it is very, very sad that the Punjab government, at the time when I offered the project, was half here and half there. They couldn't protect the idea of the they never understood what was happening. And petty politics, third-rate politicians who were just threatened by my presence, they were allowed to attack the premises of the Anād Foundation on the 4th of August 2015. It was not the first attack. Before, some of the walls we had created had been vandalized, broken. Some of the gates that we had done were broken. One of our classrooms, they came and just one night painted that it was some office, when it is clearly our classroom and it is not something that they have renovated. So there was a whole effort, and when I was not there, they attacked. They threw everything out. And now, in spite of having a government changed, it has taken nearly 1.25 years for me to be invited back when it should have been one of the first orders of business. And even when I was invited back on the 13th of May, I was manhandled by the Punjab police. Two of my students, Vikramjeet and Simran, were actually also beaten. Their turbans desecrated. They were put behind bars without any official, without any jurisdiction, and illegally, basically, unlawfully placed under arrest. For what? For being with me and photographing me? What was happening? And how was I there inside? At the invitation of the Chief Minister of Punjab, who is also the Home Minister of Punjab. The Inspector General of Police of the Jalandhar Range was to come with me on that day as well. And he told me the night before that it is okay, the Senior Superintendent of Police, Kapurthala, is aware, and you just, without, not a problem, you just go to the killer. In spite of the fact that I was manhandled, assets which cannot be, whose value cannot be quantified in terms of money, whether it is tens of millions of dollars or hundreds of millions of dollars worth or more, they were destroyed. What I have written in my, that this would tantamount to genocide of the Gur-Sikh heritage and its resurgence. It is the only story of cultural resurgence of heritage, of the Punjab, of the historical and geographical Punjab. And to decimate it, to destroy it the way they have done, it is something more sinister. It is not something that meets the eye, there's something more than meets the eye. And we're not fools. And their wish was perhaps to provoke me. Was it? Would be my question. As I was being manhandled, I told the cops, I said, that's one thing that was missing from my CV. I'd never been manhandled, pushed and pulled by any police force in the world. And I was laughing as they were pulling and pushing me, taking me towards the jail. And I laughed and told them that thank you very much that you filled that. I can proudly state it. And they didn't know what to say. And then they said something derogatory about, we'll tell you this and that. You think whoever you are. I said, well, I'm a nobody. But one thing I'll assume that perhaps what you do, I've heard stories that you hang people upside down. You strip them of their clothing, and then you pour cold water and beat them. I said, you wouldn't have perhaps found one like me. Try your hands at me today. Let us see what you're capable of, and I will allow you to see what I'm capable of. So I was just basically laughing. It took me until telephones from senior officials and politicians came, and they were reprimanded what the heck they were doing. And then they were running right, left, and center. Oh, we didn't know it was you. Oh, you should have told us. I said, who? Your bosses and their bosses knew that I am coming. Why am I to call you? Who the heck are you? I don't even know you. It was your superiors, it was incumbent upon your superiors to tell you. If that chain of command has somehow not worked, you all are responsible. So it has been very unfortunate how things were done, how heritage, precious heritage, irreplaceable heritage was destroyed. My entire lifetime's work, they have tried to sabotage it and fatally wound it. And I'm carrying a lot of trauma inside. I'm not traumatized, but I'm hurt. And I'm affected, yes. I'm affected not because of any anger or any anguish. I'm sad at the apathy and callous attitude with which some of the officials who should have handled with much more, and politicians even, who should have been alarmed at what has happened, who should have called me and at least expressed regret. The only politician to call me was Sunil Jakar, the president of Indian National Congress, Punjab, who expressed his embarrassment to me and said that he felt somehow responsible because he was in the core center, he and the Honorable Chief Minister of Punjab, Captain Amarinder Singh. They were the ones who invited me back. And I have enough people in between the chain of command to know that it was not the state's intent to invite me in one hand and backstab me with the other. I know that for a fact, and that is why I have tried to control the narrative and not let the narrative go out of my hands, because mischief mongers will play with create havoc in Punjab. They would malign the name of the current government and officials and bureaucrats and politicians and police officials who have only intended good. And those Vizcans will paint, would attempt to tarnish the image of the Sikh, Sikhs who have been very, very open and openly called for, independence in the wake of persecution and within the country and attack on the Golden Temple. Supreme Court has said that they have the right to free speech. But to malign their names, they will also use that. So I've had to control and be very objective. But I just cannot understand. The sadness, as I said, is that nobody can guarantee. It took me 31 years to do all that which I had done. I don't know if I have 31 more years. And if I had 31 more years, would I be interested in repeating what I've done in the last 31 years? Is that the price the Punjab government and Punjab's people want to gift me with for having cared for their heritage when they were all deliberately and advertently, inadvertently decimating their own heritage? Is that the honor they are bestowing me with, endowing me with?